Tonight, more on a story that could save your child's life.
It has to do with window blinds, and last weekend a toddler died in his crib. He got caught up in the cord from his window blinds. He was strangled. Edgar Miller's death has brought to light a danger in so many homes. The danger is window blinds. It's a danger Roxanne Nodden knows firsthand. Her son Jake died nearly 4 years ago when he was strangled in the blinds in his bedroom. They'd done everything they thought was right.
Because the window blinds are supposed to be safe. You know, you tie the cords up out of reach. The window blind industry tells you that it's safe, and you just trust that. I had never heard of inner cord strangulation.
Roxanne sued the maker of her window blinds. She won an undisclosed settlement. Now she is on a crusade to educate every Mainer, every American about the dangers of window coverings. Blinds, Roman shades, bamboo shades, anything with a cord that could be made into a noose.
Now Roxanne isn't the only one, of course, trying to get manufacturers to change their practices. A national organization dedicated to this specific danger wants the Consumer Product Safety Commission to tell parents that no cords are safe. News 8's Keith Baldi continues our coverage with more on that and some alternatives on the market that could save a child's life.
In this educational video produced by the group Parents for Window Blind Safety, the organization's director demonstrates the variety of ways a child can be strangled in what seems like a harmless household mini blind.
The tassels become tangled together and form a knot.
And it is because Linda Kaiser lost her own child, Cheyenne, in 2002, that she wants every parent to know what can happen to them.
Ideally, any window covering that has a cord in it can strangle your child.
Linda spoke with us from St. Louis today about her efforts to get state lawmakers and the federal government to mandate changes and the Consumer Product Safety Commission to inform the public about the dangers of cords. That agency does not advocate completely against corded products and recommends using retrofitting devices to improve safety, something Linda strongly opposes.
Well, that's the first thing I'd like done is, you know, force the industry to be honest with the public and tell them these cords will kill your children. Tell them that. Don't just tell them, well, use a safety kit and your kids will be okay.
There are some things out there that people can do.
But Bob Moses, owner of Curtain Call, a custom window treatment business, says getting manufacturers to change or the government to mandate strict safety standards may be tough.
I think it's a situation where the public needs to be educated as best as possible. But there are a lot of people that don't give it a second thought because they don't have kids.
Moses says beyond safety retrofitting, there are alternatives.
Probably the safest product on the market in that there are no exposed cordings at all. No tilt mechanism, no exposed cords, period.
For people who don't want cords near their windows at all, and they simply don't have enough money to change every blind in their house with cordless models, there is another option. These simple traditional roller shades only cost a few dollars, and there are no safety concerns at all. And until those who make the products or those who regulate the products change, parents will be the only ones who can make the difference. In Scarborough, Keith Baldi, News 8, WMTW.